Hello, this is Kevin Megan again, and it's time to do something with this here compost barrel. So, first we need to find a location for it, and I like to have it reasonably close to wherever the source of compost is. If you're throwing garden waste in here and nothing else, then you want to put it in your garden. In my particular case, it also gets the refuse from the kitchen and other things that we can compost out of the house. So I want it in an area where I can get at it on a regular basis from the house, so I don't have to keep it in the house too long, and I'm not tempted to procrastinate in that particular area. The other thing is, you may or may not want to have it right directly in the sun. If the sun gets to be ridiculously hot like it does here in Missouri in the summertime, it might be better to have it somewhere where it's somewhat shaded so that it can stay reasonably cool, because eventually there are going to be earthworms and stuff in here, and we don't want them to die from the heat. So what I'm going to do is, I have some a stand of bamboo growing here, and then Daisy was so nice as to dig me a hole right next to it so I don't have to dig a flat spot, and we'll just set the barrel right in that flat spot. And now we're going to fill it with some stuff to get this thing started. Now, what you put on the bottom needs to be some kind of a cushiony mat that will allow water to go through it. You wouldn't want to throw newspapers right on the bottom, because the newspapers will act like a plug and plug up all those holes. So we want to put grasses and straws and things like that on the very, very bottom, just to preclude that, and also to allow the worms to come up from down below into the barrel. And quite frankly, I don't have to add worms to this barrel. They will find their way into this barrel once the material inside starts to decompose. But as the summer goes along, I pick up worms out of my driveway. I'll just throw them right in here. It's as easy as me keeping a worm compost barrel somewhere else. We get double duty, and then if I need worms to fish with, I just scrounge through the compost and come up with some worms. So what are we going to put in here first? Well, I got a whole bunch of wet refuse from the rabbits here, manure and straw, and I'm going to put that in the bottom of the barrel first. The straw will keep things loose, and of course the rabbit manure itself is already mostly fiber and digested material. It really could go straight on the garden just the way it is, but I prefer, since I'm starting a compost barrel, to start the compost barrel with something in the bottom that not only is going to provide for drainage in the bottom of my barrel, but also it has the nutrients necessary for the starter for this compost barrel. So we don't have to worry about inoculating this with any kind of bacteria or anything. It's already going to be right in here, ready to go. So I'll get my fork out and we'll fork that in there, and then we'll take a look and see where we go from there. All right, it makes for kind of a messy looking deal, but quite frankly, the nice thing about rabbits and some other farm animals is that their waste byproducts just don't stink. And if they do, then you probably have something wrong with your system for keeping the stuff clean. If there's plenty of air available for the stuff to decompose aerobically instead of anaerobically, you won't have that smell. So, brings up another topic. What can go in here? Well, there's a lot of things that can go in here, and there's a few things that should never go in here. I put almost everything that comes out of the kitchen in here that we don't eat that is biodegradable. The only exceptions to that, I don't put any meat products in here at all. It might compost down and it might do just fine. The problem is, you might run into yourself a problem with salmonella or E. coli or something like that that you don't want. So I don't put it in here. I do, on the other hand, put dairy products in my worm bin and in here, because if you put them at one end or the other, eventually they break down. Doesn't seem to have any ill effects on the the worms at all, and certainly in just a short period of time it's going to break down. Don't ever throw cat manure, dog manure, or any kind of meat-eating type material from their excrement in here, because they can carry diseases that people can carry, and there are certain diseases that can be really, really hard on people. Torn up newspapers, shredded egg cartons, paper towels, now not the plastic paper towels, but the actual paper towels that don't have the plastic fibers to hold them together. They rot down quite quickly. Kleenexes, toilet paper, those kind of things, obviously not the ones that have been used in the restroom. But if you use it for cleaning up around in your kitchen, no problem at all. Just throw it right in here and it'll break down very quickly. Eggshells, potato peelings, any kind of vegetable waste from your kitchen. Grass clippings, any kind of plant waste from your garden. You want to be careful with some plant waste from your flower garden. If it's a particularly poisonous plant, then it may not be the best thing to have in here. Not because you're going to eat this stuff, but perhaps it could do some damage to the worms and stuff that are in here. But typically, if you would throw it out in a pile and let it rot down outside, you can put it in here. Upon occasion, it doesn't hurt to sprinkle a little bit of dried laundry detergent on top if it's a good biodegradable type laundry detergent. It will help to break the fibers down in the plant better. And not too much. You don't want to kill your earthworms, but it also helps it to retain moisture. Now, I don't have that problem since I put the rabbit manure in here, but your compost barrel can dry out, so you want to make sure that on a regular basis it gets slop water also. So when you bring your greens and stuff out from the house, bring it out in a bucket with some water in it and pour it in here, and that water will work its way down through and help to keep this system moist. The worms and the bacteria and everything are going to find the level that they're happiest at. They're going to start out down there on the bottom probably and use it up, and they'll slowly work their way to the top. So you don't necessarily have to stir this barrel, because this barrel has air holes in it to allow oxygen to come in from the outside and to allow for a reasonable amount of drainage. I never found it necessary to stir it. Another thing you might want to remember is keep it far enough from your front door so that annoying flies and whatnot won't come into your house from here. But at the same time, if you're putting stuff in here that's drawing annoying flies, you're putting the wrong stuff in here. Typically, garden waste and things from the kitchen will draw flies that are drawn to plant material, and therefore they're not going to be the ones that bite you or bite your animals. They're going to be soldier flies, perhaps. They're going to be black flies. Any of those, their larvae are extremely efficient at breaking down compost and turning it into soil. Now, how long does it need to stay in here? Well, it depends on how active your system is. If it's really active, you may be able to use this soil next year out of this barrel. You may be able to supplement your garden with it as toward the middle of the year. The only thing I can say is when this barrel is full and it's done an awful lot of work, it might be well to find a place where you can take it, tip it upside down, and start your process all over again, or start a new barrel. Because once this has got a tremendous amount of its digestion done, then it could be put in a trench where you're going to garden next year, and it would be all ready by next year for anything you're going to do. This should get hot inside. The temperature should get warm, especially with the new stuff added. So most plants and seeds and whatnot that would be thrown in here will die. If they don't, then I recommend you cover it up with something that's opaque to keep the sun away from it. And in a short period, any of those seeds that germinate will just die. So next year, when you put this on your garden, you will have not only nutritional soil for your garden, but it will also be sterile in that particular instance, in that there won't be any seeds left in here to worry about germinating and coming back in your garden. Now, I mentioned earlier in one of my videos that this is not absolutely organic, because I don't know the origin of the straw. It came off a farmer's field, and I'm going to guess that they used pesticides and herbicides and all that kind of stuff. I also use pesticides on my rabbits when they have ear mites and stuff like that. So I don't know if you could certify this as being organic or not. I will say it's mostly natural, and I can tell you that after it's been through a compost process of several months, that probably any of those chemicals that would have caused you a problem are at least diluted tremendously, if not already eliminated by the bacteria and whatnot that goes on in here. You have to understand that nature is a phenomenal critter. If you look at any videos of Chernobyl, where all of that horrible, nasty stuff went on, when the reactor melted down, there are animals and plants living all around there without any problem at all. So, whether they've neutralized this radiation or not is hard to say, but at least the radiation has localized itself into areas, and now nature has taken back over again. Same way with this kind of stuff. If you leave it for any length of time, it breaks down and would eventually probably break down to the point where it just ran right out into the ground. Brings up another point. Downhill from this barrel is going to be very fertile. So right here next to this barrel would be a very good place to plant something like potatoes or whatnot. They could get their nutrition from this barrel while they're growing, because whatever goes in the top and runs out the bottom holes is going to fertilize the soil right next to it and all around it. It's another reason that you might plant this right smack in the middle of your garden, is because whatever plants are planted around it are going to get inoculated all summer long and all winter long with whatever comes out of here. And that's why, and I'll take you up and show you, I planted some things up here in my garden. This is exactly what it looks like. It's a bathtub, and it is full of this winter's rabbit manure and water, because we've had a fair amount of rain. Now the water is mostly at one end, the other end is mostly dry. It makes a phenomenal compost barrel, simply because there's a drain in the bottom, there's a drain at the top, and so the water can run through it, and the flow that's coming out from the barrel from down here at the bottom is going right straight into my garden. So the garden is getting constantly inoculated with the nutrients from this bathtub. And I have another bathtub. I'm going to do exactly the same thing with it. I may punch more holes in the bottom of it so that it will drain better. But, you know, if you can have a bathtub at one end of your garden that's higher than the other end of your garden, then you may very well be in a position to constantly be feeding your garden just simply by throwing stuff in the bathtub and letting it compost and letting the compost run out into your garden. I also put piles of rabbit manure up here at the top of the garden and along the sides on the uphill side, so that as they deteriorate, the water that runs through them will go down into the soil right here, right next to them, where I'm going to plant my plants here very shortly. This is a trash can. Trash cans work really good for compost barrels, especially these black ones. You want to get one that's fairly heavy. The cheap, flimsy ones aren't going to last. This compost soil that's in here is all finished. It's done. I don't know if you can get a good look at it or not, but it is complete. It's ready to go on the garden. It's actually been in here a little over a year. And once again, there's a drain on the bottom. So the drain allows the moisture that comes in here to run out and to fertilize the garden around where this is located. This is a stainless steel tub out of a front-loading washing machine. It has little tiny holes all around it. It is a phenomenally good little critter to place out in the middle of your garden and to throw compost in, because the compost, once again, will deteriorate in there, and as it deteriorates, the nutrients will come out through these holes, the worms will go in through those holes, and it becomes a self-sustaining little ecosystem all by itself. If you bury it just a tiny little bit in the ground, maybe just even an inch or two, you'll find that you may have to dump it once in a while, but the material inside will collapse on a regular basis as the earthworms and whatnot come in here and get it. And it requires no attention whatsoever. Just throw whatever in there. This happens to be, once again, full of rabbit manure. I have an abundance of it. There's more over there. So what am I going to do this summer? Well, we'll talk about gardens later. But that's a good update for composting. I hope that did you some some good, that you learned something. If not, maybe reinforce something that you already knew, or else you're going to say, oh, that guy's, he's just nuts. Well, yeah, but my nuts stuff generally works. I don't get it all for myself. I steal it from other people because I find that as a community, we do a whole lot better than we do as individuals. Anyway, that's it for right now. I'll let you go. I'm going to try to get this thing uploaded so that we can watch it at aroundthecabin.com. And if not, then I'll post it and I'll just tell everybody about it. Ken Bacon. Bye for now.